Now, she won fans for her roles in McLeod's Daughters, Always Greener and Winners and Losers. But Michala Banas has us in Stitches as Amber Wheeler in Upper Middle Bogan. Let's take a look.
I got it.
Way to go, Mom! I'm getting changed. I'm getting changed.
Go easy. Looking good, babe.
You're not supposed to have him overnight.
Says who? Well, other than you and that mediation lady.
It's about looking after him. What did he have for dinner last night?
I can provide a meal for my son. I know about the food groups.
Oh, the food groups. Oh, break it down for me, Troy. What food groups did Sean have last night?
He had two all beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickled onions on a sesame seed
bun.
Go
home.
Oh, who can resist a slip and slide? But look, what many people might not know is that behind the scenes, Michala has been fighting a personal health battle. At the age of six, she needed a life-saving operation to stop her body from poisoning itself. Michala joins us now from Brisbane to tell us more. It's good to see you, Michala. You're so talented and funny, but many people might not have known about your health battle. Can you tell us how it affected you?
Yeah, I just was really unwell for the first 6 years of my life, and no one could work out why, and I kept getting these infections, and my parents, thanks to them and their parental instincts, went, something's not right, we've got to go get another opinion. I went to another doctor and they checked out my kidney, and I went straight into surgery, emergency surgery, which ended up being life-saving surgery. And, I'd been born with this defect, and they had to remove most of the left side, or most of my left kidney and part of my bladder in this operation. And, yeah, it saved my life. So I'm pretty grateful that my parents trusted their instincts and went and got another opinion. Because, yeah, my body had been poisoning itself due to this defective kidney that I had. And now, unfortunately, my little nephew, who's in New Zealand, he's only seven, he's been born with two severely undersized kidneys. So it's very likely he will need dialysis or potentially a kidney donation. There he is. That's Luke.
Oh, Luke,
or
yeah.
Potentially or a donor. So there's no cure for kidney disease. It's dialysis or kidney donation. And so I've just joined up with Kidney Health Australia as their ambassador, because obviously it's a really personal thing for me, and I just want to spread awareness about it all, because it's the statistics are terrifying, you guys.
They really are. There's 25,000 Australians who live with kidney failure, and as you mentioned there, astoundingly, there's no cure. This October, you're supporting the Red Sock Appeal. What is that, and how can everyone get involved?
So there's a bunch of ways you can get involved. I know it's a tricky time for a lot of people, depending where you are in Australia, but there are on October 10, there are a Red Sox Appeal walks happening, if you can do that during this time. If not, there are online challenges you can do. You can just buy a pair of red socks and wear them about town like I am in these photos. So casual. Oh, there I am, casually leaning with my red socks on. You can do that in the park. Or you can just donate. And all the money goes to supporting families who are suffering and dealing with kidney disease, and also research, which is a really important factor, because 63 people in Australia every day die from kidney disease-related issues. So this is a huge number, and it's, yeah. I think, you know, all you have to do as well, I'm just encouraging people to make it part of their medical checkup as well. It's just part of your blood test. Just ask for your kidney function to be checked when you get your blood next blood's done, because it's as simple as that, and just staying on top of it to help prevent anything going wrong, because you can lose 90% of your kidney function before you have any symptoms, and then it's too late. I know, it's scary.
How's your health now, Michala? Is it an ongoing process to make sure you keep on top of your kidney health?
Yeah, look, my health is really good. I drink a lot of water, I take care of myself, and I get checked up all the time. I get my kidney function checked, and I have to do a couple of extra special checkups for the one good kidney that's serving my body very well. You can live with one kidney and live a perfectly great life, which I do, so I'm very grateful.
Oh, beautiful.
Fantastic, really important. Yeah, in a change of pace though, Michala, Something we also didn't know about you, you're also one of the very few intimacy coordinators in the entertainment industry. How did you find yourself in that role?
Oh, look, you know, it's a new role in the industry. Yeah. It's basically, I liken it to a fight or stunt coordinator, but for intimate content. So intimate scenes, kissing, sex scenes, working closely with children, childbirth, all these sorts of things. There's been no one to sort of support these sorts of scenes in the past. And I came across this work about 3 years ago. Eita O'Brien from the UK was brought to Australia. I went to her workshops and then I got sponsored to go and train with her in the UK before COVID hit, which was really fortunate. And I've been doing it ever since, sort of juggling that with my acting. But it's just a really important role to support actors and directors and the crew in telling intimate content really safely with really clear consent and boundaries and making sure that everyone's supported, you know, throughout the process, because it can be really embarrassing, confronting, tricky stuff to navigate. So it's supporting that.
It's very, very important. We spoke to Eita here about it as well. It's very, very important.
Yeah,
it's great that you're on board
amazing.
With it. Yeah.
She's
superb.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, it's a great role. I'm really, really thrilled to be doing it, as well as juggling some acting stuff at the same time. So lucky.
You have your hands busy, full, I should say. You're busy, that's for sure. Michala, thanks so much for joining us today. We really appreciate you chatting to us and also that
thank
really
you
important
for having
message.
Me.
Yeah.
Of course. Thank you. I'd love to look at it as well.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys. Thanks.
Good on you. Take care.